Hello everyone, welcome back to Coding with T. Today we are going to create the third video of our Riverpod State Management course. In this video, we are going to learn StateProvider, the provider which is going to change the state, and we are also going to learn how to implement it, how to change the state, and also how to trigger a button event. And on the click of the button or the icon button, we are going to change the values of the provider, and we will see how the whole app is going to be redrawn, and also we want to only redraw the specific widgets. As you can see, this is the playlist of our course, and if you're new, you can watch the previous videos. Link is in the description of the complete playlist, and also I'll drop the link on the right top corner, so make sure to watch the previous videos. So without wasting time, let's get started. So we are inside our project that we created in our previous tutorial, and in the previous tutorial you see I have created everything in the main.dart, but today I have segregated these things into different folders. I'll drop the link down below in the description of the complete playlist. Previously I created everything in the main.dart, but now I have decided that I'm going to create different type of folders for each video, and you can grab the whole playlist or the whole source code from the GitHub. I'll drop the link down below in the description. And now onwards, we are going to focus on the main.dart will remain same. We have wrapped the provider scope, which we learned in detail in the first video, and then also we see in action in the second video of this playlist. I'm not going to go into the details of provider scope, but definitely this is the code of video one. We created string type of static provider, integer provider, double provider, all these providers are created, and we learned that we can also create different type of instances that we can later on use in our projects using this provider. So this provider is a useful provider, and also we cover consumer widget, widget reference, and what is the difference between reference.watch and reference.read. Again, we will cover these things today, and we print them on the screen. So for today's video, I have created another folder, and in the video two, it is a simple consumer widget, or you can call it a stateless widget. Just change the status widget to consumer widget, and you just have to add next to the build context, you have to add widget reference so that we can easily access all the providers that we created anywhere in our widget. So in this widget, I have app bar, floating action button. This is the icon button. So when this button will be triggered, we want to update the state of the provider. And this is the text where we are going to display our counter value. So first of all, we need to create provider. Today, as you know, we are going to create counter provider. We are going to cover the counter example. So I'm going to name it counter provider. To create a state provider, by name you can see it is a state provider, so it has a state that is attached to the provider. Means now state can be changed, and whenever the state is changed, we want to redraw our user interface. So let's create state provider. Make sure you have all the packages that we added in the previous tutorial, and once we have the state provider created, add a semicolon at the end. And as you know, as we also talked about the provider in the previous video, that every provider is a function. So also, you can see whenever you're going to write any provider, it will ask you to create a provider function inside these brackets. So to create a function, you know, we have these brackets to create a function, parameters, and then a function bracket. Now inside the parameter, only one thing is required, which is reference. And we covered this reference in the previous video as well. Again, I'm going to repeat it. The reference is kind of a similar thing as widget reference. So this reference is again pointing towards the provider scope, where we have all the providers already in place. So this reference is going to help us to refer all the providers, and we can use Riverpod other features inside the providers as well. So this reference is specifically designed to handle cases in the providers, but this widget reference is specifically created to handle all the cases related to user interface. When we reach to the future provider and stream provider, then you will understand this thing in a better way. So for now, we have to create a reference as a parameter in this function in any provider. So we have a straight provider. In the last provider, you see we just returned one value, and that value was not changeable by the user interface. But today, again, as it is a counter, so by default I'm going to return 0. This means it is going to be an integer type of provider. When you hover over this, you can see it is a straight provider of type integer. Now we created a provider which is simply an integer provider. Now we want to use that provider inside this widget. So let's call this as counter or counter provider, but I'm not going to use the similar names. So final counter is equal to, we have to use the ref object, remember, ref dot. Again, I'm going to explain that we have two things. We can call the watch parameter, and also we can call the read parameter. So both are going to work similar. Like the read is going to only read for the first time when the build will be created. This line will be executed by the compiler. So read will read read the provider value and return that value over here. So that value will be used down below in the widget. That's it. That is not going to again remember whenever the value will be changed in that provider. It is not going to redraw the user interface. So the read will only work once. But as we want to make sure that whenever there is change in the counter provider that we created above, we want to redraw the user interface. For that, we have to watch some specific provider. So the provider is counter provider, and that's it. So this is the provider that we want to watch. By name, as you can see, that provider means, if we convert from English to any native language, provider means someone who is going to provide you something, right? So this provider is going to provide us an integer value. So once we have that value from the provider, if you hover over this counter, you see it is a type of int. So this is int counter, because we are going to get the value as integer, and simply we are going to paste that counter inside string and just convert it dot to string. So this is now a string value. Let me also run it first. I'm going to run it in the Chrome. So as you can see, our application is running and we have the app bar state provider tutorial as a value. Currently it is 0, and down below we have a plus button or floating action button. So floating action button is not going to do anything, where we have the state provider value, a default value, which is 0. Now we want to change this value and we want to trigger this event using the plus icon. So the next thing is, inside this function, we have to add the value inside this counter. So I'm again going to call reference. If you see that this counter is not actually going to work, because it is just a return type or the return value from this counter provider. It is an integer. So it is the resultant value that we receive. So we cannot use this counter dot something like. So we again have to call the reference or the ref dot. This time we are not going to watch the changes or whatever current value of the provider. So before going to trigger the new value, we first have to watch for the current status. So we just have to call reference.read. This time the read means only when the button will be clicked. You just have to trigger this, or to get this value, the read the value of this provider only once, and name of the provider is counter provider. But here we have a trick, because provider means, as I told you earlier, that provider means it is going to provide you something. But this time we want to provide something to the provider, or we want to notify the provider that, okay, we have this new change. So you have to make these modifications in your value. So for that, what we are going to do, not outside the bracket, inside the bracket, we are going to write call the notifier. So notifier means again, who is going to notify this provider that, okay, something is going to change. And we have a lot of functions, not a lot, but the specific function that we are going to deal with, the state function, means the state is actually a value, which in this case is an integer. So we want to update this state, and simply call plus plus means the state is going to be incremented. So this notifier is going to notify this provider only one time using this reference, which is pointing to the provider scope, and it is going to change its state. You see, it is a state provider. So we have a state object. So state is actually int in this case, because its return type is integer. So this integer will be plus plus, means we are going to add one plus plus one value in the state. So I hope you understand. If you have any questions, again, you can ask me in the comments and I will try to answer all of these. Control Alt L. Now we have the on press event. So I'm going to save this. Okay, it's running now again. So click on this plus icon and you can see it is redrawn to one. Again, plus, and it is changing the value. Now if we see that how it is going to rebuild, I'm going to add a print statement. So before we're going to return any widget, I have added a print statement, which is going to tell us that build method is loaded. So if we are going to see that the whole widget is being built, or only this text is being changed, because we are just changing the text. We do not want to change app bar, floating action button, but this is a small case or the smaller example. But as compared to any real class or the real widget, we quite possibly have a lot of values or the lot of widgets. So we do not want to redraw all the widgets. Rather, we want to make sure that only text should be redrawn. So let's see if this print is going to be triggered. This means the whole build is being executed again. So let's save it. You see build method loaded. And now when I'm going to click on this plus icon, you see build method loaded again. Again, build method loaded. So as many times as I'm going to click on this plus icon, so build method loaded means the whole widget is going to be redrawn whenever I'm going to click on this plus icon. But we do not want to use this approach. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to wrap this text widget. If you're coming from the background of getX, you remember that we wrap single widgets inside OBX. So I'm going to wrap this widget with a widget called consumer. It is not a consumer widget, because you see consumer widget is over here. So it is a consumer, and before child, it is going to be have a builder method, and in the builder method we have three things. Again, builder is a function as any other builder that we use usually in any widgets. So it is going to have a context, again a widget reference. You see this reference, and again we have the widget reference over here. So then we have any child widget. So inside this function I'm going to return this text to remove this child. So we're going to return the text, but this time you can see this counter is coming from the build method. It is using this reference of this build. We are going to remove this right from there, and we're going to use this local reference of this consumer widget, and inside that I'm going to create this reference. Now this counter is actually coming from this local reference. It should now redraw this simple text. So again I'm going to copy this print inside this builder method, add this print, and let's say consumer method loaded and build method loaded. So let's try to see which one will load. So at you can see we have build method loaded and also consumer method loaded. This means that both loaded properly. Okay, let's click on this plus icon, and you can see consumer method loaded. Let me clean this, and now let's click on this again, and you see whenever I'm going to click on this plus icon, it is only going to load the consumer method, not the build method. This means that the whole screen is not being redrawn, rather only a text widget is being changed. So this is what we want, and this is how easy it is to use Riverpod in your applications. So that's it for today's story. If you have any questions, you can ask me down in the comments, and if you are new to this channel, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified for all the upcoming videos. And once again, if you have any question, you can head towards codingwidget.com/contact us page, and you can reach us directly, or you can also ask us in the down below in the comments. So thank you for watching, and take care.